I was the first to sit down with Twilight stars Robert Pattinson and Kristen Stewart. It was their first interview since their headline-making scandal, and they had plenty of things they wanted to talk about, starting with a very heated love scene, which even impressed Taylor Lautner.
It is mind-blowing. Ah. I was not there in the bed, obviously, but
I was under it.
But as a viewer, it's insane.
I haven't seen it. I'm gonna say, really?
Well, I have seen it, and the Edward Bella love scene in Breaking Dawn Part 2, out November the 16th, is, as Taylor says, insane.
It's pretty good. I was thinking, I would be so self-conscious, because it's so close in on your face.
Oh my God, but, yeah.
I can't even imagine.
The worst was when he was like, we wanted to be really inside of the experience, and so for your close-up, you're not gonna be looking at Rob, you're gonna be actually just looking directly into the lens.
Oof.
You're like,
Oh,
I don't think they used any of those shots.
Yeah, that's a little
awkward. I don't think so, yeah.
That was funny, though. That was great.
Because you see yourself when you look directly into the lens. You can just
see
your reflection. Yeah.
That was awful. So embarrassing.
Do you ever crack up? I mean, how many people are in the room when you have to do that scene?
There wasn't many.
No.
I think people don't really want to watch either.
Robert, I think that they do.
Yeah, they're all like, pointing and laughing.
And now at ease with Edward and Bella's relationship, Jacob.
And the love triangle is over.
Is it? That's true.
In this movie.
Fell in love with a baby.
Jacob actually imprints with their baby at the end of part one, leading to a truce amongst the three.
Yeah, I know it. Fall in love with a baby, Taylor.
What can you do?
What up with that? How did it feel going into this, knowing then that huge part of the storyline was done?
Very weird. I mean, when I had to say to them, you two look great together, it was just strange.
You guys really look great together.
You'd make a great baby.
That baby, Renesmee in the movie, and an author Stephenie Meyer's Twilight series of books that have sold 120 million copies, prompts a Twitter question.
Would Taylor consider returning for a sequel about him and Renesmee?
I mean, I'd consider anything.
Well, I'll have you know that I just interviewed Stephanie, and she actually said that there was a little crack in the door, that it's not open.
It's not open, but there's a little crack.
And everybody's saying that you're kind of leaving the crack in the door a little bit open.
Someday, maybe. Uh-huh. It might just be like right before I kick it, I'll tell everyone what happens, just so I won't have it die with me, or at least write it down for somebody.
Anything that comes from Stephenie Meyer's brain, I would consider to its fullest degree.
I think there are 100 different avenues that it could go down. I mean, that are very unexplored, but I find that we have uncovered. I think if anything else happens to Bella and Edward at this point, I'm just gonna be like, I don't care. Just kill him. Just kill him. No. But I'm saying, like, I think at this point they deserve their happiness.
It's
like,
true.
Just leave them
alone.
Be now.
You got a favorite cherished moment?
I like it when you disrobe.
Now we know.
There you go. There it is.
You just blushed a little bit.
I'm blushing more than a little bit.
Oh, I think a lot of girls would agree with Kristen on that one. Well, here is tonight's Twilight tip. More than 100 pairs of contact lenses were used on Breaking Dawn Part 2. Now, Taylor was the lucky one. He actually never had to use them in the film because he's not a vampire.